Hi, my name is Felicia. I'm in Ohio, and I'm going to go over some of the questions on the combination test that you're going to receive. In Ohio, it's a total of 25 questions. Some states is 20 and some is 30. So I'm just going to go over a few of them to give you an idea of what to expect on your test for combination vehicles. Before you back under to the trailer, the trailer brakes need to be locked. You should not back a tractor under a trailer until the whole air system is at normal pressure. You are coupling a semi-trailer to your tractor, but have not yet backed under. The trailer is at the right height when it will be raised slightly when the tractor is backed underneath it. If the service air line comes apart while you are driving a combination vehicle, but the emergency line stays together, what will happen right away? Nothing is likely to happen until you try to apply the brakes. Which part of the kingpin should the locking jaws close around? The shank. When should you use the hand valve to park a combination vehicle? Never. The fifth wheel locking lever is not locked after the jaws close around the kingpin. This means the coupling is not right and should be fixed before driving the coupled unit. The air leakage rate for a combination vehicle, engine off, brakes on, should be less than 4 psi per minute. You have coupled with a semi-trailer. In what position should you put the front trailer supports landing gear before driving away? It is fully raised with the crank handle secured in its bracket. The air leakage rate for a combination vehicle, engine off, brakes on, should be less than 3 psi per minute. Why should you be sure that the fifth wheel plate is greased as required to prevent steering problems? There are two things that a driver can do to prevent a rollover. They are: one, keep the cargo as close to the ground as possible, and two, go slowly around turns. After you supply air to the trailer, make sure the air lines are not crossed and the trailer brakes are working. This is done by applying and releasing the trailer brakes and listening for brake sounds. Semi-trailers made before 1975 that are equipped with air brakes often do not have spring brakes. You are coupling a tractor and semi-trailer and have connected the air lines. Before backing under the trailer, you should supply air to the trailer system, then pull out the air supply knob to lock the trailer brakes. The safety catch for the fifth wheel locking lever must be over the locking lever for a coupling to be complete. I hope this helps you on your combination vehicle test. For more questions, there are a lot of CDL testing online that have the questions and the answers that are going to be on your test. And at the end of this video, we will have some resources that will help you out. I hope this helps out and helps you. Good luck.